मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, सो क्लास 3 इज ऑल वेरी एक्साइटेड टू नो योर लेसन इन इंग्लिश एंड डूइंग ग्रेट वर्क विद वीडियोज. आई एम रियली हैप्पी टू सी योर वर्क. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू अ पोएम बिकॉज यू हैव डन टू चैप्टर्स विच विल बी कमिंग इन योर फर्स्ट यूनिट टेस्ट दैट विल बी हेल्ड इन द मंथ ऑफ जून. वन विल बी the Frog Prince, the other will be Abdul Maji, and the third is To the Market. Now this is a poem which you have to first understand and then learn by heart, and let's see whether you understand well or not. See, you don't have a book, but I believe that these pages will be sufficient for you to understand and to read them. Now this is a poem about the market. To the market, when you go to the market, what do you see? You see a lot of shops, you see shops of fruits, vegetables, groceries, your clothes, so many things. So there's a little girl, her name is Joanne. Now she goes to the market, and what does she do over there? What does she buy for all its her family members? And it's a poem about that girl. Now little Joanne goes to the market. On her arm is a wicker basket. Now she goes to the market. When she goes to the market, she has a small cane basket in her arm. You can see a cane basket. A cane basket made up of cane. Okay, she has a cane basket in her arm. Happily she skips along. So whenever you go out with your parents, with your mother, or maybe when you go out to play, the children always skips. They don't walk, they don't run. They run also, but they skips. You know, skipping up, skip karte karte chalte ho. So even she, happily she skips along, merrily singing a song. So she was skipping along when she was going to the market with a basket in her hand, and she was singing a song also. So look how they have rhymed it so well. Little Joanne goes to the market. On her arm is a wicker basket. Market and basket is rhymed. Then happily she skips along, merrily singing a song. So with along it is song. What shall I buy? Wonders she. Now when she goes to the market, she wonders. Sochti hai, kya main khareedun? What shall I buy? Yellow roses for mother dear. Yellow colored roses for her mother. Why? Because for her birthday is so near. In a trice it will be here because her mother's birthday is coming. So she thought that she will buy yellow roses for her mother because her mother's birthday is coming very soon. Apples for grandma to eat at lunch. They are so juicy and soft and easy to munch. Now apples for whom? For grandma. Grandma is mother. Grandmother. So she wants to buy apple for grandma. Because they are very juicy and soft and easy to munch. Munch means to chew. To munch means usko khana. Munching is easy for grandma because they are very juicy, they are very red and they are very soft. Ripe yellow bananas for grandma to relish. Grandpa to relish. And ripe. Ripe means bilkul pake hue. Yellow means bilkul pake, peele peele bananas for grandpa to relish. Relish means to enjoy. Relish is a word. Means to enjoy. What do you relish? Can you tell me? Tell me, what do you relish in food? Do you relish sweets? Do you relish chocolate? Do you relish cake? I think all these things you children all relish. So relish means to enjoy. So ripe yellow bananas for grandma to relish. They'll be the best he could ever wish. Now relish and wish, they have rhymed. So grandpa is also would be very keen to have such bananas. He must be wishing that I must get that yellow ripe banana. So I must buy yellow ripe bananas for grandpa. Peanuts, they are crisp and tasty. You know what is peanuts? Moofli. You know peanuts? You all eat peanuts in winters. So peanuts that are crisp. Peanuts are always very crisp and very, very crunchy, tasty. Dad will find them also crunchy. Now for dad, what does she want to buy? Peanuts, because they are very crunchy, they are very crisp and they are very, very nice to eat. Okay, my basket will be full with them all. Joanne for herself gets nothing at all. She says, now that my basket will be full because I'll be buying yellow roses for my mother. For my father, I'll be buying those crispy peanuts. And for grandmother, maybe red juicy apples. And for grandfather, what? The yellow ripe banana. So the basket is all full. There's nothing, no space left for myself. I cannot buy anything because my basket is all full. So at the end, what does she say? My basket will be full with them all. Joanne for herself gets nothing at all. So what does she didn't get anything for herself because her basket was full. So now with this, I want that you should read this poem. You should understand the poem and you should learn the poem. And again, I think we will start with the videos. The girls can get the cane basket and can just recite this poem through videos. And the boys can also just do the same with the basket. So you can also recite the poem. And if you recite in videos, the poem will be learned by heart very well by you. So with this, I would just tell you to know the meanings of these words. First is relish. Relish means to enjoy. And in that video, you can always make sentence of the words which I am telling you. One is relish. The other one is crisp. And the third one is relish, crisp, and grandma. Just make three sentences with these words along with the recite this poem in videos. So if you recite, you will remember the poem very well. And then in the next class, we will do the question answers, the next exercise of it. And I hope you can read this. And I hope you can read this poem from the video, video only. And it's very easy. You can always learn and you can always tell the meaning of this poem in your words. That a girl, little Joanne, she went to the market with a basket in her hand. She bought lot of things for all family members, but she didn't buy anything for herself. Why? Because the basket was full. And what is the meaning behind it? That she was so concerned. She was so concerned about all other family members that she forgot herself. It happens, no? When you go to the market, when you love your family people so well that you always think about buying for them. You don't buy anything for yourself. Same thing little Joanne did. That she forgot to buy anything for herself. Because when she thought that she would buy something for herself, the basket was already full. So this shows that how we are concerned about our family members, how we love them, how we respect them, and how we feel very good for them. So this is basically a poem regarding a girl who loves her family members too much. Okay, thank you.